I'm kind of nervous because these poems are kind of short, and I used to do slam before, so I'm only used to like really hype like audiences and really hype like it's like poetry has to be turned, or if not, I'm like, I'm bored, I want to go home. But you know, I'm trying to grow up. And this project was really fun, and I think it bridged some of the stuff that I've always been interested with poetry, which is first of all documentation. And I think the first time I went to an archive, I was interested like how they could document undocumented people if you can't like have particular information in the archives that will like, you know, rat people out or whatever, depending on what people are going through. And, you know, assuming that someone's undocumented and also might already have other issues with the police. So I guess that being said, I went into the archives thinking about that, but this time it was a little different because the folder I was looking at was the Black Lesbian newsletters. And it was just one box. So I just focused on that one box and the poetry of Teddy Matthews, right? And what I really loved about that poetry, and I think that's what the three pieces that I'm going to read were bouncing off, was like just myth-making and trying to imagine a body that doesn't just survive in the archives past everything that it's been through, but that can exist in poetry so that you can also imagine it, not just in the archives, but I'm like, whatever, maybe my poetry won't make it to the archives, but wherever I speak or share poetry, I want it to be archivable in the sense that I want it to be myth-making. Okay, that being said, it's actually four short poems, and they kind of go in together, and I sort of split them up again because at first they were sort of a braid, but then I was like, I'm literally a little bit schizophrenic. I'm like, there's like 30 different voices. I need to split these poems up into four. So the first poem is called Origen Making on the Stoop. And if you feel anything I'm saying, you can clap, say, like, do not be silent. Like, it doesn't have to be awkward. I really, like, want there to be a different interaction when people are speaking their art. Like, if I'm sharing something really vulnerable, you guys can, like, speak back to me so I don't feel hella uncomfortable. okay. Origen Making on the Stoop. Some say it was a snake. Coughed her up milkless. Left her a rusting uterus, crows nibbling, the last of her placenta splattered across. She is a rainfall away from telling on you. She's got a chipped tooth and a fist full of seeds. Well, my titi told me, and she knows her, that a campesina found her in a chili coffin pepper filled with clam shells. Tried to pick her up, but you know, she was all salt and shiver. Man, it had to be the ocean, if you ask me. Sick as we've made it, probably shook her off like a bad cold. She's got to be somebody's daughter. I bet she was just a young thing, gripped into romance, wanting, you know, eyes rolling back, the sting, the foam, the fishtails, to be somebody's mermaid, plastic, clay, whatever, wanting to be blanket, river, someone's warm tea. Girl. Be knife, map, tent, leather boots, wake up sandy and hungry for your life. Thank you. Ooh, I'm thirsty. Okay. The second poem is called Origen Making Outside the Bodega on Lenox. And I think some of the titles in the pieces are supposed to be geographical to where I grew up in Boston, because part of the poems that I was looking at and part of what that writer was doing was that it was based in the South. So all of the poetry and the poems that came in her collection were really based on like her geographical area. So this one's called Origen Making Outside the Bodega on Lenox, which was this bodega that I went to my whole life until I moved to California. So this was me imagining like if I was to stand in the stoop and like reintroduce myself to every time like I was there and someone was really annoying me, or like I was like trying to hide my breasts because I'm like, oh, I'm uncomfortable, but like I still have to go through that bodega all the time because my mom is like, you have to go do this, and I'm like, I don't want to bring my queer and black ass downstairs right now. So this was like me trying to imagine if I had a comeback like to that, which I usually never did. Origen Making Outside the Bodega on Lenox. I is bitter syrup, boiled embers, molasses thick. I take work. I want more. I take time, oils, and lotions, and all of your money. I'm bad for you. I go straight to the heart, be bad for the blood. But I'm all your curses, lifted, returning to myself. And you will feed me as I is. And you will bring me black coffee, no sugar on Mondays, black eggs over mounds of black beans. Thank you. What I mean when I say go, sharpen your oyster knife. I mean tell them run. Tell them there ain't much space between them and this sharp tongue. It's cutthroat. It cuts through. I mean you are no one's crime scene, no one's ghost tossed, wandering, empty-handed. I mean the last thing I thought I would do was love again. I brought her this battered body, and she praised it every time it barked back. When I say go, sharpen your oyster knife, I mean I need you to shake the earth with those thighs. I mean cut deep. They will not forget a sharp black hand. But if they do, least they'll remember the knife. Okay, and then this is the last one. It's called I Know Why Sunflower Bows. And this is really depressing too. This is like, I was walking by, you know, like towards the end of the summer, or at least in the East Coast, I don't know if it's the same thing here, but all the sunflowers just start to die and it just looks really depressing. But I'm really sad, so I get really happy when I see that. I'm just like, oh my God, they're dead. Like, it's okay. So I was like, I wonder like what else could a sunflower do, or how else I could imagine what a sunflower is doing when it's like following the sun, or what plants are doing when they're following the sun. I know why the sunflower bows. I got tired of following the sun, living like no fire in my belly, no instinct in my gut, tired of bending my neck. Tired of bending, my neck cracked, praising a fire god who wakes, sure of its light but afraid of mine. Tired and convinced that light is a thing I could follow but not find, search or live in. Listen, I ain't no bud, no newborn, no toddler flower. I've been here. I stand fixed, my direction clear, my existence brilliant. I bow because I found the sun in me. And this is not fear, is not obedience. This is prayer. Thank you.